guys, welcome back to Auto Repair, guys. Thank you guys for watching, subscribing to the channel, guys. If you have, guys, a Chevy, GMC or Buick vehicle, guys, and your AC compressor is not working, we'll show you guys how to fix it super cheap, guys. The fix is probably between $10 and $15, guys, and we'll explain what needs to be done. You don't need to waste $300-$400 on a new compressor when you can, guys, fix it for like $10-$15. Stay with us and we'll explain now. We have that AC compressor, guys, out of the Chevy Cruze, but the same design is used by many General Motors vehicles, so that will include Chevy, Buick, also GMC, because you can see on the compressor it just says General Motors. So the design that the compressor uses, guys, it's pretty simple, and it's used by most of the vehicles. So now you can see, guys, this is the clutch on the compressor. Often the clutch goes bad, but let's say you replace the clutch and the compressor still doesn't kick in. What could be the reason, guys, is you have one solenoid that controls the compressor pressure and all that stuff here. And if that solenoid doesn't work, your compressor will not work as a result. So that solenoid, guys, many people do not know about it, but it's replaceable. Just the way the AC compressor clutch is replaceable. And we'll show you guys how to do that. Now, let me explain. You can, guys, replace that solenoid with the compressor being installed on the vehicle. You don't have to remove the compressor in most cases, but you have to drain the AC system out. You have to vacuum it down, take it to a shop to remove all the freon out of the system, because when you remove that solenoid, all that will come out. So this solenoid, guys, okay, it has one snap ring right here, and we'll need to use, okay, pliers for snap ring. We're going to go, okay, here you can see, squish it in. Okay, let me just find a little bit of a better angle, because I cannot show you anything. I don't know, the light is weird, something. Okay, like that maybe. Careful not to fly in your eyes, guys. Always protect with your hand. Okay, that snap ring is out. Now this solenoid, guys, you need to start moving it and pushing it up. It might be stuck, careful not to break it. Okay, so you have to, guys, take your time. We're going to get a little bit of screwdriver and just pry a little bit up. It has a few seals inside, okay, and that's why it's not so easy to remove sometimes. Also, we can get pliers, okay, here, and we can pull on it a little bit. So let me get a pair of pliers quick. Okay, and we can do that as well. So we can get the pliers, okay, and gently move it, okay, and pull up, okay, like that. And this is, guys, your solenoid. Now, careful, because the compressor will still have some oil in it. This is, guys, the solenoid that is causing all that problem. So we'll get a new one, guys, and replace it. We'll have the links where we get our parts from in the description of the video below, guys, for your convenience. So we'll get a little bit of oil, apply on the new solenoid, guys, on the seals, because they will be dry. Okay, you need to apply just a little bit of oil. I would always recommend to use gloves, never do what we do, guys. Okay, press it in all the way. Okay, watch now. Okay, perfect. And now we need to install the snap ring. Okay, like that. You need to adjust it. Perfect. This is it, guys. So now this compressor is perfectly working compressor. So what we'll do next, guys, we'll put it together and we're going to test it and see if it works. So let's see if we have success with that one. Check it out, 35 degrees, guys, 34, we still keep dropping. Extremely cold. This one in Celsius, this is 0.2 degrees that we're blowing now. So you can see that definitely fixed our problem, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, guys. And hopefully we can save you quite a bit of money. See you guys next time.